Human rights are women's rights, and women's rights are human rights. Secretary Clinton first said this as First Lady back in 1995 at the 4th UN World Conference on Women that took place in Beijing. And here, 15 years later, it is still a statement that guides the work we in the State Department do each and every day. This week, we have celebrated International Women's Day at the Department, with Secretary Clinton's recognition of 10 inspiring women leaders, and a series of discussions centered on what we can do to advance women's rights here at home and abroad. So it is also fitting that during this week, when we recognize the courage, commitment, and leadership of so many women around the world who are advancing political, economic, and social progress, that we also release the annual country reports on human rights. From Afghanistan to Somalia, girls can't get an equal education. And likewise, women in so many places aren't treated equally in the workplace or in their respective legal systems. Our work seeks to empower and educate women and girls around the world. But to do that, we must start from a factual basis, which is why these country reports are so important. The country reports inform our bilateral discussions, our interactions with other countries within multilateral mechanisms, such as the Human Rights Council, and even the laws we make at home. The International Violence Against Women Act was recently introduced in the Congress. I invite you to review the human rights reports available on the State Department's website and to learn more about the status of women around the world.